Chris Menard here. Do you want an Outlook signature that stands out, possibly including your profile picture as an oval? Let me show you how to do it. Really, really simple. Here is a sample that I threw in here when I was just getting ready for this video. If you notice, there's my profile picture as an oval. I would change this information and make it mine. Let me show you how I did this. Microsoft has a web page for this. Create an email signature from a template. It is a Microsoft site. Here's what drives me crazy. It says start with a template. Download the email signature template. Step number one. Well, the problem is this. This used to give me a Word document with a bunch of different signatures in it. Now when you click it, and I'll have this, that page I just showed you, I will have that link in the body of the YouTube description, plus I'm going to do a blog post on this. Well, this is not what I was expecting, even though I do like this. If you notice, they have the Customize in Word icon on a lot of these. So you could easily find one of these that you like, click on Customize in Word, click on Download, open that up in Word, and you would customize this here. I like, though, the old Word document that had them all in it at one time. Fortunately for you, I had already saved it before they changed this link here. So let me go show you, because by the way, all the other steps here follow the Word document. So here's the Word document. This is what you used to get when you clicked on Download, the email signature gallery template. This will be available for you in my blog post, so you can go and get it. If you notice in here, I'm just scrolling through here. I'm not going to keep going, but there are pages and pages of signatures right here. Find one that you like, and you're just going to change the information. Every one of these signatures is a table in Word. They're even telling you the steps up here, step 1 through 4. I'm going to just keep this simple and take signature 1, copy it. You're going to go pop over into Outlook like it says and paste it. So let's do that step. I'm going to do a new email. I'm going to put it below this one just as a reference. Control V. There it is. I'm going to get rid of this. It's a table. Right click and you're going to hit delete table. I would change the, oh, by the way, in case you're wondering, when I pasted this, why didn't it not come in right? Let me do it one more time. So good example of me making a mistake. When I do Control V, and that comes in here. If you notice, the colors that we had on the template didn't come in here. You may need to use your control, keep source formatting. Word has changed the way some of the paste stuff happens. Now I come in here and change this to my information. And you're going to say, Chris, that picture is clearly not your picture. I think this is easier to fix in Word than to do it in Outlook, but it's the same steps and you could do it in either one. Just pop over into Word, make a new document, pull your signature in, either insert, picture, this device, or you could copy and paste. Let me copy and paste my signature real quick. Let me copy and paste my image, not my signature. So here you go, Control V. You're going to run into the same issue that I'm having right now. That is a great picture. Just kidding. But the picture is rectangle, and also the picture is not ready to be made into an oval. Click on your image in Word and go to Picture Format. We're going to use the Crop tool, and I'm going to hit Crop. I need to crop a little bit off the top of the image right there, and I need to crop a little bit off the bottom, because remember, this image is going to be really small with the dimensions because it's going to be your Outlook signature. Click outside, close enough to a square. It doesn't have to be exact, but the image is much smaller. A Chris Menard tip. The image you put in here, make sure it's not 3,000 by 2,600 or 2,000 by something. If it's 200 by 160 or 300 by something, keep it under 300 for the width and the height. It doesn't need to be a big image. Here you go. Still a rectangle. I'm going to go to Picture Format. Still using Crop, but I'm going to go Crop to Shape. Under Basic Shapes, there is an oval. Watch this. Just click it. Click outside. There is the picture I'm going to use right there. Now, I know that it's still too large, but I'm happy right here. I'm going to pull it in from the corners. That looks pretty good. I'm going to right-click and copy it. Back to the Outlook, over in Outlook. I'm going to click on this profile picture, hit Delete, and Control-V. And once again, I can do this from here. So I could have done it all in here right now, by the way. There we go. Change the information. Final step. The signature, let's say the signature looks great, but it's only great for this one email. You need to copy the table. I've selected the table, Control C, signature, signatures, new. I'm going to call this Menard YouTube Video Signature. Give it a good name, hit OK. The body down below will clear out, Control V. You got that table in here. Really, really important point. Those icons that are in there, if you don't want one, you can click on it and delete it. You can change them. Maybe you want Facebook in here. But I love LinkedIn, and this LinkedIn is not the URL to take you to mine. That is right up here. You're going to click on this icon and put in the correct address down below here for your LinkedIn profile. Then you're going to hit OK. Change all of these, get rid of the ones you don't want. The next step and the final step is this. Here's the signature. Do you want this to be used for new email messages or new email messages and replies and forwards? This may be a little too much for replies and forwards. I may have a different signature for that, but hit OK. That is saved. Here's the test. Close this email. Don't save it. Outlook, new email, Control N also works. And there is that signature that has been saved right there. You can always come to signatures and signatures. If you have some you don't like, you can get rid of them. Just hit delete right here. I'm going to keep it though. I hope you enjoyed this video. I will put the links for the Word document download. I also put the link to the Microsoft website that's going to take you to those other signature templates that you can just, if you find one you like, you can just click on download and use that too. I actually prefer the Word template that they used to have. Appreciate your time. Feel free to subscribe to my channel. If you like this video, give me a thumbs up. Help me with the rankings. And my online training classes are listed down below. Have a wonderful day.